ifs work a lot like other statements in Scratch, and we're going to look at what happens if we have multiple ifs in Scratch. Here in Scratch, I have a script that plays three notes, note 60, note 62, note 64. And maybe it seems obvious, but those notes play in order. Let's listen. If these statements include an if, they also play in order. Let's watch. Now, it'll play note 60. It'll check if 3 is equal to 3, which it is. It'll play note 62. And afterwards, it'll play note 64. Let's listen. If this was something that wasn't true, like does 1 equal 4, then it will only play note 60, and then we'll end playing note 64. So it'll play just two notes. Now let's look to see what will happen if we put a bunch more if statements in there. So now, if 1 is equal to 4, it'll play note 62. If 3 is equal to 3, it'll play note 60. If 1 is equal to 4, it'll play note 62. If 2 is equal to 2, it'll play note 64. So just like we could play multiple notes in a row, we can put multiple ifs in a row. And it'll do the first if, and then the second if, then the third if, then the fourth if. So this one will play note 60 because this one's true. It'll check if 1 is equal to 4. It's not, so it won't play this then case. It'll check if 2 is equal to 2. It is, and so it'll play note 64. So we should hear note 60, 60, and then 64, 64. Let's listen. A lot of programs in computer science involve a lot of ifs. And even if one if is true, that doesn't mean that another if can't be true. So that's why here we were able to play multiple notes.